Tables in PowerPoint have specific accessibility elements that need to be implemented in order for them to be accessible. The first thing I'm going to do is add a table to my PowerPoint. Now that I actually have a data table in my PowerPoint, let's take a look at some of the accessibility requirements for this table. First, all tables need to have a header row applied. To determine this, I'm going to select inside my table, then select table design. On the far left-hand side, this information, header row, first column, total row, last column, banded rows, and banded columns, this is all the information that is going to decide whether or not my table has a header. Now, if I had some more complex data in here, I might also pick first column. And if you notice, when I select that, it actually applies the table style as well. This is a good indicator that our table has had headers applied. Now, this table doesn't require a first column, so I'm just gonna leave it like that. Now, I'm also gonna show you some things that you should not do. Let's add a row below. Something that people often will do is use merge cells. This is a merged cell. Now, while it's okay to use merge cells some of the time, it really creates some complex accessibility issues if we were to take this file from PowerPoint to PDF or some other file. So, whenever possible, avoid using merge cells. Yes, it may cause your table to look a little bit different than how you want, but really it's more important to maintain that accessibility throughout your entire document. So in order to get rid of this merge cells, I'm gonna go ahead and split it, and we're gonna put it into three columns. And it's been fixed now. The last thing we want to do is give our table some alternate text. This is a table detailing how awesome Sean Jordison is. And that's it. And that's how you make an accessible table in PowerPoint.